In 2018, FIFA 19 was released, and to nobody's surprise, there were little to no changes to EA's newest FIFA game. What set me off was the fact that EA decided that we needed more Alex Hunter, as if the first two The Journey storylines weren't enough. Yeah, let's completely ignore the manager mode, the player career mode, and the pro clubs mode to continue shoving the story of a great value Walmart version Marcus Rashford down your throat. Look, my point is, this is one of the main reasons why I decided to pick up PES 2019 instead of buying FIFA that year. And I loved PES 2019. Sure, it had some issues, but it felt different to FIFA. It felt like it had more weight, the gameplay was better and more realistic. Teams would change tactics mid-game, making every match feel different, and I had so much fun playing the Become a Legend mode that I continued playing it every year since 2019. I'm telling you guys this because ever since Konami canned the PES name and turned it into a free-to-play eFootball title, the game isn't the same, and Konami is in a mess. Last year, Konami announced that they couldn't release an entire new eFootball PES title because of the ongoing pandemic. They had to opt for a seasonal update consisting of updated rosters and player models. While this did raise some eyebrows, Konami announced that they would be bringing the game to the Unreal 4 engine, and they would be making a brand new PES football title for the future. This got me excited, and I couldn't wait to see what they were developing. But in July, Konami then announced that they would be dropping the PES name and they would be calling it just eFootball and making the game free to play. I didn't know what to think of this change at the time, but I did expect that eFootball would be more of like a long-term project that would get better further down the line.
You know, year by year, start updating it. I think it's sad that, you know, PES is officially gone. I kind of thought that they were just going to move to the title just being eFootball. But as of right now, maybe it's for the long-term gain they're going for. Maybe later down the line, they start putting in a career mode. They start putting in a player career. And, you know, those come as DLC, whether it's paid or whatever. And maybe the game's going to be better for it.
On September 30th, 2021, eFootball was released and was met with horrible reviews from many sites. I reviewed the game for Sports Gamers Online, and here are some of the key things I had to say. Konami announced that eFootball PES was being converted to a free-to-play experience and rebranded as eFootball. The name change was influenced by Konami's ambition to continue its success in the esports world. The result of these changes is a free-to-play football title that is nowhere near ready to take the main stage at any esports event. eFootball is a mediocre, watered-down football experience that is way below the expectation of Konami. The game was criticized for its gameplay and terrible graphics. Overall, the game looked unfinished. Luckily, eFootball is free because I can see people being so upset at paying $60 for this underdeveloped crap. One day after release, the eFootball Twitter account acknowledged the game's disastrous launch, Konami then stating that they are working hard to improve the game. But here is where things get worse. Konami apologized for the game and vowed that their first fix, version 0.9.1, would fix many issues, and this update would be released on October 28th, 2021. And literally 2 weeks later, they addressed the fans with another apology, this time delaying the update. Oh my God, here we go. After they delayed the version 0.9.1, Konami took to Twitter again to announce that their first major update, version 1.0, is being delayed into spring 2022. I mean, this game is a hot mess right now. What's going on behind the scenes at Konami to delay an update 5 to 6 months? That just tells you the lack of development that has went into eFootball, the lack of care that Konami has given this franchise. I can see eFootball becoming an afterthought once UFL comes out and FIFA continues to improve. Who's going to play this mediocre crap? Look, I'm not trying to rant just for ranting's sake, but I had to get all the news compiled up of what's been going on with eFootball into one video. So hopefully you guys don't really hate my ranting or don't really mind it, but I had to give you guys the information that I had. So ultimately, we will have to see what happens and how does the game progress after the first update. I'll be back right here on Sports Gamers Online to tell you exactly how I feel about it once it comes out. If you guys like the content we do here on Sports Gamers Online, then hit that like button and subscribe to SGO right now. And if you want the most out of your SGO experience, then join SGO Insider.